Ben traditional roast coffee. 31-ounce containers are just $4.99.
Tell your Google Assistant to play 104.3 MyFM on iHeartRadio.
$10 for every used can of R134A automotive refrigerant. Details at cashinr134a.com.
Let iHeartRadio be your one-stop audio destination for celebrating Women's History Month. Great stations powered exclusively by females, like iHeart Country Women, Women of R&B, Women Who Rock, and many more. Playlists personally curated by some of the most influential women in music, like Taylor Swift, Kelly Clarkson, and Mariah Carey. Plus, tons of featured podcasts, like Ordinary Equality, The History Chicks, and the iHeartRadio Podcast of the Year winner, Office Ladies. iHeartRadio, number one for music, radio, and podcasting. All in one app.
Yeah!
More music.
More variety.
104.3 MyFM.
For 3 MyFM, it is Valentine the morning, 6:08. It's Thursday, March 4th. Good morning, good morning. I'm laughing already as we start the show in my head because of what I said yesterday. The autopilot of the radio personality. First opening the mouth to give you the date, to give you the time. You know, it's just very funny. It's very autopilot how to start a radio show or something, you know?
You could just say, like, how you doing?
Yeah, no, I could, but then that would become very autopilot, too. You know, I don't know. It was just weird, because I was just putting my headphones on, I was talking to Kevin off the air about some stuff, and then the song ran out, so I'm like, oh, I've got to say words. What's the easiest words to say to start your brain, and just go, hey, man, it's 6:09, it's 104.3 MyFM, it's Valentine's Day morning, it is Thursday, March 4th, in the year of our Lord, 2000.
There's a lot of stuff you could fill with, really. I mean,
honestly,
more music,
gosh.
More variety. It's 104.3 MyFM, an iHeart radio station. Proud to be an iHeart station. It's Thursday morning. Like, you could just go on for, 20 seconds.
Just like,
filler stuff.
Totally filler stuff. And then you could even do, like, some stuff we say so often that don't take this the wrong way, but Kevin always laughs at me for this one when I'm like, and I want to thank the men and women that have served our country at home and abroad for their consistent dedication to supporting all of us into the blanket of freedom and allowing us to all live this life in a beautiful democracy that we love.
And that's a true statement, but it will always get you out of whatever situation you find yourself in.
Right. There's been like, I forget what it was. We had some call that was going south, and I just came on and go, and I want to thank the men and women that have served there. And people are like, I guess we're just turning it now. And this works out great. How are you, buddy?
Good, man. Yesterday was our wedding anniversary over here.
Yeah.
So Allie and I were able to get away. We had a friend stay here with the kids. We went to lunch and...
Oh, he froze. Oh, he cut off. Did he get cut off?
What happened at lunch?
I know. It was noontime when he went. So we're missing out on the best part of the story. Are you back?
Oh, I'm back, yeah.
You cut out. You said about a nooner, and you cut out.
No, we had a friend stay with the kids, and we went to lunch. And we've really probably gone to sit outside at a restaurant maybe 5 times in the last year. We just haven't done it much.
Sure,
so
I haven't
It's kind of a newer experience for me. And I don't know if this is going to stick around forever. I kind of hope it does. The whole go, sit down at the table, scan the little QR code on the table. It brings up the menu.
Oh, okay.
You just order everything through your phone right there. You put your credit card in. You just kind of order as you go. Like, now I want to, some chips and salsa. Now I want a taco, whatever. And they just bring it to you and there's no human interaction. And I'm sure a lot of people will miss that, but I am not one of those people. This is a really easy way to update the dining experience, in my opinion.
Well, you've never been the, and I'm just going to come out the wrong way, but you've never been the most social in certain respects when it comes to, like, small talk and stuff.
No.
You know what I mean? You don't like that stuff.
At all.
You like more deep conversation, I suppose, versus than just a chitty-chat small talk on the street.
Yeah, and there's something strange about just sitting there in a chair looking up at your server and they're telling you about the specials and they're making small talk with you because it's their job and I've never been comfortable in that situation.
They're just, trying to take care of you, do their job, and maybe also get a nice tip or something, and you're like, get out of here, I don't want to talk
to you. I still tip just as much as I would have,
You should say that, have a little sign that says, if things change in the future, I don't like small talk, but I tip great, so back off.
Mm-hmm.
Are
there any barber shops that just promise no small talk? Because that's where I'm gonna go.
There are shops that promises no small talk.
I remember thinking of you specifically, Kevin, when I read this. There are, you go in and you select the option of no talk.
Oh, okay, all right.
I love that.
Do you pay extra for it?
I think it's the same price.
Is it the same price?
Yeah.
Yeah. I got my haircut yesterday. Thanks, guys.
Oh my gosh, that's
great. That's right. You're all bums. I started falling asleep though too. I love it. I'm talking to Haley for a fair amount of time. And Haley can talk, too. And I can talk, obviously. And so we're chatting away, and then I just start to doze. And that's the doze where you're not asleep, but you're kind of getting there, you know what I mean? The noise of the salon, the barbershop starts to... my barber...
You go to a woman's hair salon, it's fine.
Because I'm a woman!
It's fine! No one minds.
Well, you guys make fun of me every time I do it.
No, we don't.
Oh, my God. The stuff you say off the air, you misogynistic, crazy buggers. So anyway, I start to, nod off and stuff. But she said before, hey, if you don't want to talk or anything, if you're just tired one day, because she doesn't do it for a living, she goes, just let me know, You know what she should do? I forgot to tell her yesterday. She needs to work some thing in where she gives you a back rub or a neck massage or something. Because she does a little teaser when you're over by the sink getting your hair washed, right? Like a little teaser shoulder rub, a little teaser neck rub. Just for 30 seconds. It's a teaser, So put it on the menu, an extra 10-minute neck rub or something like that. Maybe people pay for that. Make some more money.
The place I go, they have one of those little electric gloves that they put on their hand.
I've had that at a barbershop before, too,
I think they use it to get all, the little loose hairs to shake them, to vibrate them off of your neck and stuff.
Right.
But, oh, my God, I love it.
No, I love it, too, and they use... It wasn't a glove. It was a bigger machine, but it just seems so impersonal. I don't know. I'm going to put the glove on now, put it in your neck, and go... All right, there you go.
I love it.
The touch, the tactile sensation of somebody just putting their hands on you and saying they care for you. That's what, massage therapy in some respects is all about. They realize that the movement they do with their hands is releasing that lactic acid in your muscles and giving you relief. And there's There's something very special about the human connection in that moment, instead of just turning in a glove, for me, anyway, that goes...
Well, if it's no massage or the glove, I'm taking the glove.
There you go. And if the glove don't fit... I don't know. I want to thank the men and women who served their country. All right, 6:15. Tony Jordan has the morning traffic. Tony, what's going on?
Well, unfortunately, this is a fatal crash investigation now on the 60 freeway eastbound side as you're coming up on Hacienda. It was multiple cars involved, one of them that caught on fire. Now they are saying there's a signal that's been issued and carpool three left lanes are shut down until further notice. So heavy delays there as you're coming away from 7th. Westbound side of the 60 is pretty heavy from Azusa to Hacienda. No lanes blocked off on the westbound side. Just don't look at the factory that's slowing down your drive. 10 freeway eastbound side would definitely save you some time, and the 605 north to get there still looks good so far this morning. 210 freeway westbound side just before you get to Azusa. That was a crash with the big rig. They did have all lanes stopped, so you're seeing a pretty solid brake lights as you come away from the 57. Looks like lanes have been reopened, but still heavy delays there on the 210 as you're coming through Glendora. On the 110 freeway northbound side just before Slauson, there's a car that broke down blocking the left lane of the main line. Traffic slows at Century, but it's still good speeds up ahead into downtown. This traffic report is sponsored by Amtrak. When you're ready to go, Amtrak is ready to take you, with enhanced cleaning and safety protocols and private rooms available. And with more than 500 destinations, they can get you safely and comfortably to small towns and big cities across the country. Learn more at Amtrak.com. That's your traffic. I'm Tony Jordan with Valentine in the Morning on 104.3 My FM.
From the Southern California Toyota Dealers Traffic Center, let's go places.
The SpongeBob movie, Sponge on the Run, is streaming March 4th on Paramount Plus.
Hi, it's Valentine. I realize, and I hope you do too, how important it is to take some time out for yourself to reset and relax. You know how I do it? I get lost in my Netflix. I get home a little after lunchtime, so there's a bit of time before my kid's school day is done. I've got some free time to myself. I will sit down, I'll watch The Crown. And that one's been out for a while, but there's so much amazing content that's dropping all the time. We all need a network that can keep up, especially when you're watching on the go. That's why I love T-Mobile. And you know what? If you're 55 and up, they have a plan just for you called Magenta Unlimited 55 that includes Netflix. It comes with two lines.